Hello students, today we are going to discuss about inheritance of one gene. In the previous video we have discussed about the seven traits or seven contrasting characters selected by Mendel for his breeding experiment. And now how Mendel has carried out the breeding experiment by taking one single contrasting character. So only one single contrasting character he taken into the consideration for his breeding experiment to explain the monohybrid cross, or in other word it is also called as one gene inheritance. It is also called as one gene inheritance. Why? Because here one pair of contrasting character among seven contrasting character, Mendel has selected one pair of contrasting character, that is height. By taking height as an example in the garden pea, he carried out the hybridization and he got the result, a phenotypic ratio as well as genotypic ratio. And how he has conducted the experiment, let us understand. So let us take the example of one such hybridization experiment that is carried by Mendel. So where he crossed tall and dwarf pea plants to study the inheritance of one gene. So he considered tall plant pea plant crossed with a dwarf pea plant to study the inheritance of the one gene. And for that sake he collected the seeds. For that he collected the seeds produced that is as a result of this cross, and he grew them in his he grew them to generate the plants of the first hybrid generation. And he called them as a first filial generation. And Mendel also observed that that all the F1 plants they are tall, and that is like one of its parent, means like one of its parents, none were dwarf, all were tall. So he made similar observations for the other pair of trait. He found the F1 generation always resembled either one of the parent, and that trait of other parent was not seen in them. So okay, let me recapitulate once again all the aspect, that is a brief introduction about the monohybrid cross. So let us define what is monohybrid cross. So monohybrid cross can be defined like this. It is a cross between the two different plants. It may be refers to plants also, it may refers to animals also. So whenever the breeding comes, no, so the breeding may be in the either carried in the plants or in the animals also. So there is a cross between two different plants or two different animals, and they are differing in a single contrasting character. So I told you in the beginning only mono means single. So here single contrasting characters, the two parents, two different parents, they are differing in one pair of contrasting character, that is tall and dwarf. So here the contrasting character is the height of the plant, that is the height may be tall or dwarf. So taking one pair of contrasting character, Mendel carried out the breeding experiment. But here he selected true breeding variety for the monohybrid cross. For that sake what he did, first of all he selected true breeding variety of a tall plant crossed with the true breeding variety of a dwarf pea plant. So how he got the tall, pure tall and pure dwarf. So for that sake he carried out the selfing. How the selfing is done? The tall plant is selfed for about 6 to 7 generation, then he got the pure true breeding plant. And a true breeding parent tall plant crossed with the true breeding dwarf plant. Okay, so this is the phenotype of a parent. So what is the phenotype? That is external appearance of the plant is called, that is tall. Tall is the external appearance. Dwarf is also the external appearance of the plant. So these two characters are called phenotypic characters. And these phenotypic characters plants produce genotypes. What are the genotypes here? The genotypes are, genotypes can be represented by capital T, capital T, and crossed with a small t, small t. Here capital T refers to pure tall plant, and smarty refers to dwarf plant, pure tall, that is pure dwarf plant. So this indicates the genotype of the pea plant. And the pure tall plant, along with its genotype and phenotype, it undergo meiosis. And this, as it undergo meiosis, the gametes are going to form. So the gametes, the diploid set of chromosome undergo haploid set. That is meiosis. As the meiosis begins, diploid set undergo haploid set. So capital T here, small t. So these two are the gametes formed after the gametogenesis or the meiosis. And these two are going to fuse. Haploid male tall gamete and haploid female, that is dwarf plant, both are going to, gametes are going to fuse together and to form, the resulting offspring is called hybrid tall. Why it is called hybrid tall? Because here the capital T is the dominant and small t is not dominant. So hybrid means here tall as well as dwarf, both are combined together. But here hybrid means having the characters of both tall as well as dwarf. But which is dominant? The genes, the gametes are both. Both the gametes are present here. But which is the dominant character? So here capital T is going to represent the dominant character. So since it is having both the genes, both the characters, but tall is the dominant character, hence this is called as hybrid tall plant. So this offspring is called as F1 generation, first filial generation. And then Mendel carried out, here the plants, he got tall but hybrid tall. So after the F1 generation, he selfed the F1 generation. So what is the procedure for selfing? Here hybrid tall plant selfed with the same capital T small t, the same genotypic genes ratio, genotypes we have to consider, capital T small t crossed with the capital T small t. This is called as selfing. So after selfing, he got the gametes. So here two kinds of gametes. So capital T is going to segregate separately, small t is going to separate. And capital T small t here also, thus two kinds of gametes are formed from the hybrid tall plant. So this hybrid tall plants undergone selfing. So during the selfing, each one plant produces the gametes, that is meiosis, and two varieties of gametes are formed, that is capital T small t, capital T small t. So by using checkerboard or Punnett square, Mendel crossed these gametes. That is both the side, male as well as female. So in one side male gametes we have to represent, in other side we have to female gametes we have to represent. And let us cross these gametes. So capital T, capital T. This capital T combined with capital T, it is going to form capital T, capital T. That is homozygous, tall. So here character, which character is going to appear? Tall plant. But what kind it is? Homozygous. I told you in the previous video what is the meaning of homozygous. That is a allele for a, that is a pair of allele for a contrasting character are similar. Pair of allele for a contrasting character are similar. That is called as, are a character controlled for a character controlled by a single gene is similar. Here alleles are similar. So it is homozygous, tall. Then this capital T is going to combine with the small t, is going to form a capital T small t. It is what type of plant? It is hetero. Hetero means dissimilar gametes are present here. So it is a heterozygous plant. That is tall it is. Dominant one is what? Tall. So dominant means which is going to express its character is called tall. Thus capital T small t is going to form a heterozygous tall plant. Pair of gene for a contrasting character, they are dissimilar here. Here capital T small t, here small t does not come because always the dominant gene is going to express. Next capital T small t, heterozygous tall plant. Lastly small t is going to form homozygous, but small t, it is a character of dwarf plant. So here finally After crossing, homozygous daughter plant is opted. So by seeing this chart, what we conclude? That is, what is the phenotypic ratio? So here 1, 2, 3. How many tall plants are there? 3. Is to 1 ratio. 1 means dark. Thus phenotypic ratio, that is three, we get a 3 is to 1 ratio. Where 3 plants are tall, 3 plants are tall, 1 is dark. Phenotypic means the external character of the pea plants. When we see 3 tall plants we observed and 1 dark plant we observed at the end of the F2 generation. This is F2 generation result. So this is all about the, this is F1, this is F2 generation. In a F2 generation, we get 3 is to 1 ratio. And what will be the genotypic ratio? The genotypic ratio will be 1 is to 2 is to 1. Means 1, that is capital T, homozygous tall plant is to, how many genotypes, I mean homo heterozygous tall are there? Heterozygous tall 1, heterozygous tall 2. 1, 2. What is the genotype for capital T, small t? So we have to write down capital T, small t. So they are 2 in number. Homozygous dwarf plant, how many? That is 1. So thus 1 is to 2 is to 1 ratio is the genotypic ratio of a monohybrid cross. So this is how you have to work out the problem in the examination. You will be given the examination for 5 marks also. This will be asked. You have to explain in your own words and even explanation along with the scheme. Okay, for 5 marks questions. So when Mendel crossed P1 plant, he got all the tall plants. Upon breeding one F1 generation, he got 3 tall plants, 1 drop, 1 dwarf plant. Understand? Now here one point is going to, we are going to observe. What is that? Punnett square, what is the definition? Do you know? This can also be called as checkerboard. So what is this definition is very important. Punnett square will be given in the examination for 1 mark question. What is Punnett square? The definition is very clearly given in the NCERT reader, but still let me define what is Punnett square. Punnett square is, it is a graphical representation. It is a graphical representation to calculate the probability of all possible genotypes of the offsprings in a genetic cross. So in a genetic cross, this is a graphical representation where to calculate the probability of genotype. So here possible types of genotype we can calculate, no? The possible types of genotype can be calculated. Genotypes of offsprings can be calculated by using the Punnett square. So this is nothing but Punnett square. So this is all about the monohybrid cross in detail. So we will stop here.